Namaskaram. Welcome to Natyarangam's Lek Dem program. Today is a very special program. It's being done by what I would think is the Garfield Sobers of Bharathanatyam, a five-in-one artist, SHEEJITH KRISHNA, a very celebrated product of Kalakshetra, himself a wonderful dancer, teacher, choreographer, actor, and many other avatars he has. So that's why he's Sir Garfield Sobers, the five-man cricket team. So he today is going to talk to us on choreography for solo and group dance presentations. Now, there is no one more qualified than him, I think, today to do it. Many of you would have seen his adaptation of Man in the Iron Mask in Kalakshetra, something that would not have been imagined a long time ago, a novel like that, being transformed into a dance drama. In fact, that was one of his first efforts in Kalakshetra that we got to see. After that, he has done several. He has toured all over the world. He's got wonderful students. He's a good teacher. And he's got a wonderful soulmate for a singer. So there you are. That's all I have to say about SHEEJITH. The rest of it today, you will hear from him. SHEEJITH KRISHNA. He will lead you today for about an hour and 20 minutes, lead us today, on choreography for solo and group dance presentations. There will be time for question and answers afterwards, so please engage him. I'm sure he has a lot to give us. So it's all yours, SHEEJITH.
Namaskaram. Before I begin, I would like to thank Natyarangam for inviting us to present this lecture demonstration. This evening, I am happy to speak about my choreography in Bharathanatyam, both solo and group works. I thought I would take you through my thought process, all the inputs I have had, not only in my learning, but more importantly in my life, and how over the years I have been amazed with the endless possibilities in our Bharatanatyam vocabulary. My teacher Sharada Hoffman often says that in the days of her teacher Rukmini Devi Arundel, the term composition was used, not choreography. And choreography is the word we use quite freely to discuss our creative efforts in Bharatanatyam today. Whether it is the most appropriate word or not, we can let the experts decide. First, let me tell you about the forces that shape my vision. I had the good fortune of spending 21 years studying, teaching and performing at Kalakshetra Foundation. Now I direct my own Sahrudaya Foundation, an offshoot of the great banyan tree that is Kalakshetra. At Kalakshetra, I learned Bharatanatyam from Sharada Hoffman, mentioned above, a true guardian of Kalakshetra's ideals and vision. From her and through the environment created at Kalakshetra by its founder Rukmini Devi Arundel, I understood art's true purpose. Rukmini Devi's sense of aesthetics and her unique vision in bringing together different strands of Indian culture together form the soul of Kalakshetra. Another great visionary, the philosopher Jiddu Krishnamurti, continues to inspire me every day. JK always emphasized dialogue, not as argument, but as discussion. Openness to others and other ideas, a world view that he always taught, is essential for every artist. From these thinkers, I have learned that dance is a medium that connects you to others. With any art form for that matter, There is no limit to creative expression. If you know the vocabulary well, you know how to wonder and experiment. You do not need any new alphabets or new inventions. What do I mean? Why do I say this? There is a lifetime possibility with the alphabet you already know to arrive at better words and better sentences. You need passion, skill, love, and respect. You need to understand how far you can travel within the vocabulary without repetition or imitation. But that's not enough. If you don't understand the importance of caring, preserving, following a certain discipline, respecting the logic learned from your teachers, you cannot create. When we feel the power of an idea to create change, why don't we practice it? Cultivate awareness within. Create love and happiness. Realize the power and potential for art to make a big change in life. Cultivate good eye for everything around you in life and in art. Sharpen your sense of aesthetics, texture, color, light, shade, sound, smell, taste. Your sense of the whole, absorb everything around you. Be softer, more open, ready for new experiences and ideas. Only then will doors open. You will be at peace, ready to receive dance and music. To me, that is bhakti, true devotion. If you have that eye, that vision, if you lose yourself in the appreciation of the greater whole, your dance will shine. I kindly request you to silence your cell phones, please. Thank you. In Krishnamurti's words, empty your mind and look at the sky, but not through a small window. To empty one's mind allows one to think rather than imitate. Step out and take in the vastness of the sky. In a nutshell, to me, choreography in Bharathanatyam is a way of life, a way of being, a way of extending, a way of seeing, hearing, tasting, touching, smelling, experiencing life through senses, a way of feeling. Over the years, this thing we call choreography in Bharathanatyam has become as natural as breathing for me. It is not separate from the rest of my experience. But that does not mean choreography is easy. I still have to work hard, harder now than before. I still draw upon techniques I learned through years of study and practice. As a choreographer, I have to plunge deeper and deeper into the well of emotions that is life itself. So this is what I really want to say to you. Choreography is feeling. It is a vehicle for bhava, emotion, a fundamental concept in Indian poetics and a fundamental aspect of life. It is the ability to feel deeply and translate feelings into a language that others can readily understand. It is the desire to communicate feelings across cultures and communities. It is fine-tuning one's empathy towards the feeling of others and sensitivity to both beauty and ugliness. Finally, choreography is love. Love of images and imagery in life and art. Love of music, both human-made and in nature. Love of humanity, love of nature, love of the values you cherished and seek to uphold. Choreography is the experience of oneness with the world around us. It is also a celebration of diverse human experience of humanity itself. Keeping that in mind, we want to demonstrate a scene from one of my very initial brew production, Martian, meaning man. The message of the particular production is this: share and feel the togetherness of mankind and to work for a better world with peace and harmony. A scene from Martian later included in the production Pravaha, a thematic performance on the journey of cloud, rain and river, tracing this journey from the beginning of time to the present. Inspired by the elements, early humans start making music and dance. They recognize, they listen, they feel, they experience from nature. Inspired by the elements, early humans start making music and dance. While seeking shelter from thunder and rain, they hear falling water droplets. Melody and rhythm are born, and dancing begins as elemental union with nature.
Dim, 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 dim 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 dim
Thank you.
nature, the sound of bird calls, the breeze, the river, the trees may be an influence at the subconscious level, as nature can inspire all art. Sa ti ga ma pa da ni sa sa ni da pa ma ga re sa sa ti ga ma pa da ni sa sa ni da pa ma ga re sa sa ti ga ma pa da ni sa sa ni da pa ma ga re sa sa ti ga ma pa da ni sa sa ni da pa ma ga re sa sa ti. You may be thinking that something wrong with me, because I don't stop, keep singing the same. Even if I could sing the swara with Shruti Shuddham, clarity, swarasthanam, etc., if one repeat this more than 3 or 5 avartanams, somewhere the music is dead or monotonous. So how do we create music? I focus here particularly on the creative process for Carnatic music. Yes, Carnatic music composition is a very conscious act, one important aspect of which is creating patterns, be it simple or complex. So patterns creates music. It is all about creating patterns. Basically, in this type of music, a simple pattern by itself may not be sufficient. How do we avoid such sameness, such repetition? We create patterns, that is yati. The rhythmic concept of the same name, yati, is the 9th element of Taladasha Prana, one of my early solo compositions, which can be performed as part of a margam. While discovering the concept of yati, I wanted to choreograph an item on this concept to educate audiences about certain conventions in our form. You could say I wanted to show in a simple way why dancers do tadinginnathum or kittathakatharikittathum several times. I was truly fortunate that S. Rajaram of Kalakshetra, teacher and mentor of many including me, composed the beautiful music. The verses were written by Nirmala Nagarajan. But what is really yati? What really yati is? An arrangement, a pattern, a group of syllables arranged in a beautiful combination that gives a particular shape and conclusion to the music. In total, there are 6 different yatis: samayati, mridangayati, damaruyati, gopuchayati, srotovahayati, vishamayati. Variations in the pattern are the lifeblood of music. And put simply, these variations are called yati. And in this particular composition, the patterns don't exist just for themselves. They come together with the words, melody, and movement to tell a story. Shiva dances and his devotees are watching his Ananda Tandava. Through his blissful dance, Shiva protects the whole world. And through his Tandava, we experience the patterns of the entire universe. We will demonstrate 2 different yatis here. Gopuchayati. Syllables are arranged like a cow's tail, broad at the top and tapering to the bottom. With Gopuchayati, the devotee can imagine Nandi's tail. I have used yati as an opportunity for hasyam, humor. Shrotovahayati. Arrangement resembling the flow of a river, the narrow origin and broader course. Using Srotovahayati, I have depicted the flow of the Ganga, the pattern starting as a trickle and widening into a mighty surging river. The choreography represents the movement of cosmic dancer through vertical and horizontal space, highlighting the different mandalas, exploring the dimensions of space, time. Presenting yati. Communicate love, to envision human oneness, to deepen understanding of humanity, the choreographer's most important instrument is bhava, emotion. The term bhava comes from the Sanskrit root bhu, meaning to become. It means emotion, feeling, or expression. Let us not break down the concept of bhava. We have sthayi bhava, vibhichari bhava, vibhava, anubhava, sattvika bhava. Together, these bhava elements help transform sthayi bhava into rasa. And the rasa is the artistic enjoyment felt by the audience, created by the performer using nritya, nritta, and natya. Abhinaya. Just as rasa theory involves artist and audience, the term abhinaya means to carry towards. This meaning implies two positions, a carrier and a receiver. The connection between these two positions forms the circle of communication. Abhinaya is the communication of an idea, thought process, message to the audience with the help of certain tools. The Natyashastra lists four kinds of abhinaya: Angika abhinaya, Vachika, Aharya, and Satvika. The purpose of Angika, Vachika, and Aharya is to support the Satvika of the artist. Satvika abhinaya is what touches the Rasika or Sahridaya and conveys emotional truth. I wanted to point out something important here. Although the choreographer is the main person behind the work, many other elements contribute to the final output. From our teachers, reading, observing other choreographers, discussions with co-artists like the script reader, music composer, inputs from trusted friends and scholars, all these are the silent contributors to that final presentation. And how can we forget the final link between choreographer's vision and the dancers? The dancers are actors, of course, without whom the vision is not complete. The dancers' participation plays a huge role in the process. This can happen in two ways. The dancer should be able to execute what I am imagining exactly, or sometimes the dancer's movements inspires me to fine-tune my ideas. We learn together. Let me take a moment here to introduce Sahridaya repertory artists who are envisioning my ideas today. Manjari, Akhila, Anusha, Rajamalli, Prithvija, Nidhish, Jayakrishnan, Lokesh, Deepa, Natasha, Brishti, Nirali, and sound by Rakesh. To create rasa with bhavas, I have used dhvani, mashrana nritta, metaphors, and imagery in the choreography. These concepts are essential for a choreographer using the language of Bharathanatyam. I come now to the idea of dhvani or resonance, central to classical and medieval poetics. According to Anandavardhana and Abhinava Gupta, dhvani creates meaning and generates feeling within the rasika. Without dhvani, there is no rasanubhava. What exactly is dhvani? Dhvani literally means sound. It also means resonance, echoes. Think of a temple bell that rings loudly. It sets off a trail of sounds diminishing in volume. Those resonating sounds are dhvani. Or imagine a still pool. Drop a pebble and watch the concentric circles. Those ever-widening circles are dhvani. Dhvani is also the suggestions, shades, implications, and indirect meanings we find in art. The more sensitive we are, the more sounds we will catch, even as they fade into the distance. A work of art has the power to suggest something far beyond the surface meaning, the superficial content. It stimulates us to think differently, indirectly, because art thrives in the spaces between words and images, sounds and silences. Let's demonstrate an excerpt of a composition, Panchakshara Stuti, to discuss the term dhwani. Panchakshara Stuti verses dedicated to Shiva, the supreme yogi and nartaka, attributed to classical philosopher Adi Shankara. Each verse center stages one of the five sacred syllables, Namah Shivaya, in extolling Shiva's form and divine attributes. In most interpretations of Namah Shivaya, the five syllables are associated with the five elements, earth, water, fire, air, and akasha, the space. As a choreographer, I wanted to investigate the power and resonance of Namah Shivaya in two ways. One, I wanted to stress the cosmic aspect of Shiva, his relationship to the universe. Two, I wanted to connect the idea of Shiva as the universe to the idea of the dancer and the dance. The core theme for my interpretation can be found in the ancient Tamil text Thirumanthiram, expressed at the very beginning of the piece. The particular information was shared to me by Mr. Jayachandran, scholar, researcher, and a dancer. The lines Nagendraharaya Trilochanaya Basmankarakaya Maheshwaraya roughly translate to, I meditate on Shiva, whose garland is king of snakes, who has three eyes. I meditate on Shiva, whose body is smeared with sacred ash, who is the great Lord. These lines are first sung as sloka, without rhythm, going beyond the literal. The dancer depicts a serpent coiling around the Mooladhara chakra, just below the navel, depicting pure energy, kundalini, flowing through all the chakras, ascending to the chest and above the forehead, taking you to moksha. The journey of this energy is life's journey, at the end of which the body becomes ash. The very ash we see smeared on Shiva's form. Shiva here is the embodiment of the whole world. Panchakshara Stuti.
Trilochana.
another composition to highlight the idea dhwani, sadrishyam, meaning resemblance. Sadrishyam is a varnam length choreography of a grand musical composition, a sapta raga tala malika kirtanam by Tanjay Nalwar, anchored in dutika bhava. The sakhi reveals the situation of the pining nayika Devi to Lord Brihadishwara. She describes the stages of the Devi's pining. This composition allows a choreographer to fully explore the grandeur of Gana ragas in the broad sense, Todi, Purva Kalyani, Bhairavi, Kalyani, Kambodi, Mukhari, and Varali. The names of the raga and tala are woven into each verse. The corresponding jatis heighten mood and illuminate action. A composition with musical and lyrical richness as well as philosophical depth, sadrishyam lends itself to more elaborate treatment, to subtle manodharma. It presents exciting challenges for musician and choreographer alike. Now to show using the term dhwani in choreography for the sahityam, to set abhinaya hands for the sahityam. The sahityam is munagidadu inidu isaikave manam urugiye hatayogi enavume amarndai murai idu agumo pugavillayo iduve migamugariyil. Her heart melting, the Devi pleads wordlessly. But you are immovable, seated here like a yogi. Is this fair? Will she not weep? Even though the sahityam telling you the particular word meaning, the dhwani, we create a parallel sahityam to enhance the particular idea, the particular meaning of the word. The dhwani here is the rising love for the nayaka surges forth as waves and heart beats in anticipation, but she controls her emotion and pleads with him in a voice as soft as the humming of the bees. At one time, he encouraged her love, and now he remains aloof like a yogi. And Sakhi is pained to see them in separation. The fish-eyed Nayika wallows in her sadness. The other interesting fun I had while setting this hand, which of course the audience may or may not notice, is showing the atatala angas, which this stanza is set to. The music is set, particular stanza is set in atatalam. Atatalam is also a long tala cycle. So she shows, like Nayika is waiting for too long. Atatala is also a long tala cycle. The tala, they are separated. The way you do drutam, you beat and the flip. So that indicates one got separated from the other. And I use that to indicate their lengthy separation.
Yeah.
after dhwani, the term mashrana nritta. Adding to this rich vocabulary, the Natyashastra contains a term mashrana nritta. According to this concept, the dancer can hold nritta hastas and perform pure nritta, through which meaning and root emotion can be conveyed. The body movements and gestures form their own language, creating both meaning and mood. Mashrana nritta is mostly used in dance dramas. The main examples that have inspired me are the dance dramas of Srimati Rukmini Devi, where often swaras and jatis portray the emotions of characters, whether Sita or Rama or Ravana. The nritta becomes a parallel language to sahitya, layering and deepening our aesthetic response to character, situation, and story. I want to add something here. The beauty is, whether people understand or not, there is no loss. What audiences and dancers look for is already there, that is nritta. You will find the existing classical patterns in the language of Bharathanatyam. The purity of nritta remains. But there is another layer for the choreographer to attempt, for dancers to enjoy, for students to learn, for audiences to feel. Please note that in Mashrana Nritta, it's not Abhinaya Mudras set to Nritta movements. Instead, your Adavus and the Nritta Hastas are used to convey the meaning of the Sahitya, mostly. We will demonstrate two jatis from a varnam, Mate Malayadvaja. The Chollikattu composed exactly like the margam of the music. The jatis composed exactly like the margam. I mean exactly with the meter of each word or sahitya. So one can sing the Chollikattu if needed and can feel the music better. And the nritta will suggest the meaning of the particular sahitya. As you all know, Mate Malayadvaja Pandya Samjate Matanga Vadana Guha. So the Chollikattu is also will recite along with the music.
Malayadvaja Pandya Samjate Matanga Vadana Guha Mate Malayadvaja Pandya Samjate
Madalang Kutaka Diku Taka Tadinginatum Ta Jam Janutum Taka Tam Tattadhim tum nam tum dhe tajjanu takkata jam takk jam tam tadhim tatam tatri takkadhim tatri takkata jam janu tum takkatam tattadhim tum nam tum dhe tat jhan no tak ta jham tak jham tam tat dhim tat tam tat tri tak dhim tat tri tak tat jham jhan no tum tak tam tat tat dhim tum nam tum dhe tat jhan no tak ta jham tak jham tam tat dhim tat tam tat ti tak dhim tat ti tak tat jam janu tum tak tam tat tat dhim tum nam tum dhi tat janu tak tat jam tak jam tam tat dhim tat tam tat ti tak dhim tat ti tak ta.
We will demonstrate one more jati from the Anupallavi. The way I composed the jati is again exactly following the music, like shato dhari shankari, shato dhari shankari, tam tom tari jham tari, ta kum je tari, that is for Chamundeshwari. Even the sound of the Chullikatti is also exactly following the Sahityam. Shato dhari, tamto dhari, jamtari shankari, Chamundeshwari, ta kumjetari, taddhana tattari, jamjetari. So you are able to sing.
Shatodhari Shankari Chamundeshwari Chandrakaladhari Taye Gauri. Shatodhari Shankari Chamundeshwari Chandrakaladhari Taye Gauri.
Katadhingi natum tam tum tadri dhalang kutak dikudak tadingi natum tam tum tadri jam tadri ta kum je tadri ta dhanna ta tadri jam je ta dri tam tum tadri jam tadri ta kum je tadri ta dhanna ta tadri jam je ta dri tam tum tadri jam tadri ta kum je tadri ta tadri jam je ta dri tam tum tadri jam tadri ta kum je tadri ta dhanna ta tadri jam je ta dri jam je tadri jak je tadri 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 tad jam tadri tadri tad dhanna jam tadri tadri tadhanna junnu jam tatti tatti tadhanna junnu dimmi jam tatti danna danna junnu junnu dimmi jam je tatti jak je tatti 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 tadjam tatti tatti tadhanna jam tatti tatti tadhanna junnu jam tatti tatti tadhanna junnu dimmi jam tatti danna danna junnu junnu dimmi tatti danna danna junnu junnu dimmi jam je tatti jak je tatti jam je tatti jak je tatti tari dana dana junnu junnu dhimi jam je tatri jak je tatri junnu je tatri jam je tatri jak je tatri junnu je tatti tari dana dana junnu junnu dhimi jam je tatri jak je tatri junnu je tatri kitta je tatri jam je tatri jak je tatri junnu je tatri kitta je tatti jam je tatti jak je tatti jannu je tatti kitta je tatti jam je tatti jak je tadikita je tadijam tadijaka tadijana jana kuku dare tadi dana janu dimikita taka tatikita tum kitta takka tatti kitta tum kitta takka tatti kitta tum
shato dari shankari
jam tadijaka tadijana jana kuku dare tadi dana janu dimita kitta taka tatikita tum ta kitta takka tatti kitta tum ta kitta takka tatti kitta tum
shato dari shankari
jam tadi taka tadi jana jana kukundari tadi dana janu dimita dikita taka tati kita tumta di kita taka tati kita tumta di kita taka tati kita tum
chato dari shankari chamundeshwari chandra kala dari paye gauri chato dari shankari chamundeshwari chandra kala dari paye gauri chato dari
Yet another example from the same varnam. Usually when I deal with deities, I look beyond iconography of the deity to connect it with the symbolism. In Mate, this demystifies Parvati and help us to connect to her with human emotions of motherly love, protection, etc. Here you can notice that I have used Pataka Hasta mostly to bring this idea forward.
Pandya samjate matanga vatana kuhamate malaya swaja pandya samjate matanga vatana kuhamate malaya swaja pandya samjate matangavatana guha mate malaya dwaja pandya sanjate matangavatana guha mate malaya dwaja pandya sanjate matangavatana guha mate mala Tanga Vadana Guha Mate Malaya Dvaja Pandya Sunjate Matanga Vadana Guha Mate Malaya Dvaja Pandya Sunjate Matanga Vadana Guha Mate Malaya Dvaja Pandya Sanjate Matanga Vadana Guha Mate Malaya Dvaja Pandya Sanjate Matanga Vadana Guha Mate. Malaya Dvaja Pandya Samjate Matanga Vadana Guha Mate Malaya Dvaja Pandya Samjate Matanga Vadana Guha Mate Malaya Dvaja Pandya Samjate Matanga Vadana Guha Mate
My wife Jyoti is traveling, so I had to trouble Akhila all of a sudden. Sorry about it. Now, an example using Masrananirta for Swara from the Saptaraga Tala Malika Kriti. The first raga is Todi, the Sahityam. Ninain Dodi Vanden, Nina Duruvam Kana Virayind. I ran here to you to describe how Devi suffers as she longs for a glimpse of your divine form. That was the Sahityam. The Swara in which the dancer only uses Nritta, mostly. And that contains this message. Your Nayika, thinking only of you, is overcome by both joy and sadness. Moved by her helpless state, I consoled her and came to you as fast as I can as her messenger.
Yeah.
now to another example for Mashrana Nrita with Meyadav. Why Meyadav for evocative or bhava-soaked Nrita? Meyadav is beautiful and simple. In performing it, your body reacts to lighter elements before getting into the complexities of a kauri. Doing the Meyadav prepares your mind and body for a major action. This preparation of mind, body, soul, and heart is an often overlooked aspect of performance, indeed, of the creative process itself. It requires alertness, the need to be present in every moment. Let me now explain how I have used Meyadav for the Desh Tillana, composed by Sri Lalgudi Jayaraman and set to Adi Talam. The composition celebrates the beauty of Murugan. All of us know the story of Murugan's birth. I thought Mashrana Nrita would be the perfect means to convey this creation story, where we navigate the journey of the formless divine through beautiful images from nature, the light, the lake, the lotus. Using Meyadav, we show the Krithiga maiden, one who looks divine, and the lake where the light falls on the lotus and turns into the baby cradled by the maiden. Later, when Parvati embraces each form, she gathers them together and six become one. Desh Tillana, Meyadav for Mashrana Nrita.
Tadim tadim nadridhim tatondridhim dhiranatana dhiranatakadim 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 tadim nadridhim tatondridhim.
For me, Chollukattu or Jathis, I always consider that as yet another language. Sometimes I think we can speak through Konnakol. When I had to compose, choreograph a Vachana Kavite, written by Bharatiyar. And Natyarangam asked one of us, like me, to present for the Bharatiyar festival. And gave me the Vachana Kavite to compose, where you don't mostly won't find the meter. The poetry doesn't have, it's because it's a prose, the written Sahityam is in a prose manner. So composing Vachana Kavite, because where you don't find meter into music, okay, of course we can sing in a free form like Virutham. But I thought, let's do that by adding Chullukattu, like a parallel Sahitya for the particular Kavite, and created, choreographed that particular item. It's about Sun, Nyayiru, and let's watch that. So the what I did, I looked at the words, the meter of the first particular word, and then try to incorporate with the Chullukattu. Like takata dhimita jam jam olita ruvadi yaru, in that sense. So takata dhimita jam jam tat dhim dhim tat dhimita kitta taka jam jam olita ruvadi yaru teerada ilamai udayadu yaru tangata tat dhim kadataka tat dhim தத்திம் தத்திமித்த கிட்டத்தக்க வெய்யவன் யாவன் இன்பம் எவனுடையது மழை தத்தக்கடத்தக்கதற்கெடுத்தும் கண் எவனுடையது தஜம் எவன் தருகின்றான் ஜம் கடத்தக்கத்தங்கடத்தக்கதற்கெடுத்தும் தத்தித்தும் நம் எவன் தருகின்றான் உயிர் எவன் தருகின்றான் ஐ வாண்ட் டு யூஸ் தத்தித்தோம் நம் எவன் தருகின்றான் பிகாஸ் தத்தித்தோம் நம் இஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் சிலபிள் வென் ஐ லேர்ன் மிருதங்கம் ஆர் இன் வென் டான்சிங் So taddi tomnam is like our uyir. So taddi tomnam yavan tarugindran, uyir yavan tarugindran. So taddi tomnam yavan tarugindran, uyir yavan tarugindran, taddhim. Taridhana janudhimi dhim. Janudhimi dhimi kitta taka dhim. Janudhimi dhimi kitta taka kitta taka taka kitta taka dhimi taki dhimu ta tankadataka darakadataka dhum. Ta tankadataka darakadataka dhum. Ta tankadataka darakadataka dhum. Metaphor and imagery, which brings me to metaphor and imagery, a choreographer's most important tools to express their inner workings of the heart or mind and outer realms. Metaphors, when rooted in strong visuals and images, are an important means to map abstract onto concrete, feelings onto thought, physical onto metaphysical. In other words, in order to grasp and express the intangible, our innermost thoughts and emotions, we rely on sense experience in the physical world. Metaphors give shape to bhava. Their ringing resonance or dhvani produces rasa. Metaphors that capture nature's rhythms and movements heighten the workings of both nritta and abhinaya. Through metaphor, we realize that whatever is manifested on the outside is really within and vice versa. In my own work, any nature metaphors and imagery are an opportunity to embrace the interconnectedness of diverse life forms to show how humans are connected to the natural world, a connection we sometimes forget and ignore. An artist has a body, mind, emotions, both innate and acquired from experiences of life and art, with which to create. In addition, we have the techniques from our art form, its language of gestures and expressions, and the ability to absorb the other arts, music, poetry, literature, visual forms, and the dance of nature through our various senses. All this rich experience, together with that intangible element called intuition, forms the soul of Bharathanatyam and the Bharathanatyam choreographer. Now to some examples aimed at illustrating the concepts of outlined above. Vanamam Kalyani Orpal Virumbiya Vangara Marba Vasam Paindar. She who embodies lush beauty yearns for your embrace. For the swara, I wanted to draw out this metaphor of lushness in nature connected to Parvati's beauty. The metaphor is the flower. I created a nritta sequence in which the dancer is surrounded by a thick carpet of flowers. Among those flowers, the most beautiful is Parvati. The dancer picks her way carefully through the blooms, appreciating the beauty and life of each. Let's watch. Images are important to choreograph. Now to another example from a thematic work, Ode to Great River Ganga. I believe this piece reflects both a connection to nature and the desire to connect ancient myth to an urgent message for today. And though the different poems used here are from another time, they make us understand the importance of the river to all life. Rivers must flow in full strength and richness and majesty, unpolluted and free. Rivers must be loved. I wanted to make this connection clear through dance. On a very personal note, even though I want the dancer to simply bring the words of the poets to life, he or she must feel my love of Ganga in the choreography, a feeling I had as a child. Of course, not sitting in front of Ganga, but sitting beside a stream. I would spot a buffalo floating in the water, a bird sitting on a tree in silence and stillness. And then the bird would alight on the buffalo and pick off the insects on its hide. I would sometimes chase the leaves, skipping and floating along the water's surface, and sometimes gaze at the fish underneath. I sense that you could see all of life, birth, maturation, death, decay, regeneration in these waters. And so, in this piece of choreography, you can feel the river's agility, her quietness, her curves, and the depth of experience she carries within her. We are not present.
Kshapakshi turaga uraga kopida varanova varinasyam janana marane klesha dukha sahishnu Kshapakshi turaga uraga kopida varanova
Moving on to dance drama presentations. Don Quixote and Ram Katha, which I will discuss in terms of bhava, even simple angika abhinaya, and that creates rasa. A 21st century Bharathanatyam adaptation of a famous 17th century novel by Miguel Cervantes. Sahridaya Foundation's Don Quixote, which I directed and choreographed in 2015, blends music, dance, and theater to unfold a timeless tale from Spain in the idioms of classical South Indian forms, Bharatanatyam and Carnatic music. The 15, sometimes more, ensemble production features an original Carnatic-based score featuring over 60 professional musicians. The production was scripted by Akhila Ramnarayan, and the music was composed by Jyotishmati Sheejith, with Sai Shravanam as our music director. The story of the so-called knight Don Quixote and his faithful sidekick Sancho Panza, who go on a series of comic adventures usually ending in disaster, is a familiar one. Though this satire I saw, Cervantes upholds the ideals of daring to dream, to fight for what is right, to strive for something better in a materialistic world. I was clear that people should not go back after our performance of Don Quixote, thinking they saw a production in which a madman imagines things that don't exist. We, Akhila Ramnarayan, Jyotishmati Sheejith, and I wanted audiences to understand that Don Quixote lives in each one of us. And that Don Quixote is all about the power of dreaming in the face of others' disbelief, even laughter. It is about how to face life and how to dream for a better world. I will now present two examples from the production. Three examples. The first example, we see an elderly gentleman, Alonso Quijano, lost in the world of books. He is obsessed with ancient stories of chivalry about knights saving beautiful maidens from dragons. In this scene, I was faced with the challenge of depicting Don Quixote's passion for books and his slow descent into madness. How does one to represent the hectic inner activity of reading, which can look so passive on the outside? I found a solution. I had Don Quixote on stage right, reading about his favorite knight, Amadis of Gaul. A group of dancers on stage left, each represent Don Quixote and his state of mind. As the dancers transform into characters in books and then become the emotions stride in Don Quixote's mind, one dancer continues to depict Don Quixote. Through the dancers' movements, we see the pages of a book being turned. The pages of a book being turned and different emotions spilling out of each page. Emerging from each page, each dancer depicts one of the Navarasas. Each rasa is accompanied by its own unique raga. The voice you hear is that of Vidwan Sri OS Arun. Book scene from Don Quixote.
My friend, we have work to do. All these people have come to hear your story. But is it good enough? Does it stand the test of time? Wondering who I am, aren't you? I am the narrator. I tell the story Describe the characters, move along the action, fill in the gaps, all the things the narrator of a great novel is supposed to do. I'm your best friend. Don't believe me? Let me prove it to you. Somewhere in La Mancha, in a place whose name I do not care to remember, a gentleman lived not long ago, one of those who has a lance and an ancient shield on a shelf and keeps a skinny nag and a greyhound for racing. Good people, I don't quite know how I got here, but here we are, Book and I, ready to tell you our story. And what a story! It all begins with one man's passion for books, magic, and the shining ideals he holds so dear.
Thank you.
and another scene from Don Quixote may be a good example for Angika Abhinaya. In one of Don Quixote's adventures, two flocks of sheep approaching, and that creates a cloud of dust. Don Quixote thinks they are two armies approaching from opposite sides and later attacks them. Here I only used mostly Angika Abhinaya to show the clouds of dust along with the moving goats.
Sancho! Sancho! See that cloud of dust! A large army is advancing towards us!
Senor, there's another coming from the other direction!
Now to Ram Katha, my 2017 production, an intimate exploration of the Ramayana through bhajans, collaboration with Vidwan O.S. Arun. Ram Katha is based on Ramcharitmanas of Tulasidas and traces the journey of Sri Rama from birth to coronation. In one particular scene, I have used the idea of Maya, illusion, which is the cause for all the events from Sita's attraction to the golden deer, that is Maricha, to the abduction of Sita. We will show only a small excerpt from that scene, from the end of Ravana's Patra Pravesham and Shurpanakha's lament. All these episodes unfold in an edited fashion, since it is a very well-known story. Scene from Ram Katha.
Thank you.
I think it's time. Without much explanation, we will conclude. Two more presentations from Don Quixote. The most famous scene from the book, Don Quixote, The Adventures of the Windmills. Let's look how the patterns are created with Angika. Absolutely.
The Adventure of the Windmills.
Thank you.
Okay, we will conclude here. I thank Natyarangam for this opportunity. My key motivation and challenge as a choreographer is to explore and understand nature within and nature without. At a time when our environment is in grave peril, the choreographer needs first to be a Sahrudaya who responds with empathy, love and humility to life and art. Choreography itself becomes a continuous striving, in this case, in the language of Bharathanatyam, towards a deeper awareness of the world around and beyond us. Thank you all.
Maybe one or two questions.
Thank you.